शंकराय च मयस्कराय च नमः शिवाय च शिवतराय च त्र्यम्बकं जगामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवकरं मारुवारुकमिव वन्दराजितो मुखीयमामृता।
हेलो गाइस, दिस इज के सिंह, वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजर। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल ओम एस्ट्रो ज्योति लर्निंग वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजी। सो टुडे वी आर विद अ वंडरफुल मंथली प्रिडिक्शन फॉर पाइसिस असेंडेंट एंड पाइसिस मून साइन पीपल। नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज इन देयर डेस्टिनी फॉर दिस वन मंथ फ्रॉम सेप्टेम्बर 16th टिल अक्टूबर 14, 2020। नाउ लेट अस बिगिन विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम। ओके, सो the first thing which I am looking at your 11th house is Saturn present there in own sign. A good thumbs up for you, my friends, Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people. This is a wonderful period. Any malefic in the 11th, especially Saturn and Mars, does excellent in the 3rd, 6th and 11th. Saturn is in 11th. So yes, this 2 years is for you. This 2 years means the rest of the year, best until Saturn is transiting into Aquarius, are for you guys. Just rock it up, because this Saturn is going to give you foundation for everything. Every wish will be fulfilled and everything will be done. Theek hai? Okay, now the second thing is the 10th Lord Jupiter in the 10th house creating a Hamsa Yoga. This is good. Mars in the second house, okay, not very good, but own house, you have to see that. Rahu and Ketu in the 10th house and 4th house axis. Venus in the 5th house, Sun and Mercury in the 7th house. Now, for career and wish fulfillment, this is an excellent time. But for relationship, this is not a good time. Why? Sun, a natural malefic, a separative planet in the 7th house, not good for your relationship. Plus with Mercury, which is MKS, Marankarakasthan, and also a very bad planet for the 7th house. Mercury is not at all good for the 7th house. Yes, but it is the Lord of the 7th. So definitely it will try to help out. But ultimately, you cannot expect too much out of Mercury. Okay. Jupiter in the 10th house is usually not very good, but in the Kendra, it is making a Hamsa Yoga. And also, Jupiter is the Lagna Lord. So, this is good period for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people. Mars in the second definitely will give you some moments which might make you to speak nonsense against anyone. So try to calm yourself down at that moment of time. Rahu Ketu in the 4th and 10th axis will definitely give you, or rather already have given you, a lot of change in the home and the career. Because these two axes, whenever are coming in any house, it represent a complete change or makeover of everything. Like when it is in the ascendant, the person himself change very much. Or when it is in the 7th house, 7th or 1st axis, the person changes or the environment changes. But in that 4th house, that person's home and career both changes. So this is one thing which we have to take into consideration. But this is already now Rahu and Ketu is going to transit in the next sign. So in the next slide, we come in the next slide. And here we are having... the three planets are changing here. Now they are Mercury, Venus, Mercury and Rahu Ketu are making a change in 23rd of September till 29th of September. For this week, I'm trying to give the prediction. At this moment of time, Mercury is in the 8th house and Rahu and Ketu are coming in the third and ninth axis. Now, Rahu in the third axis is very wonderful. And Ketu in the ninth axis is also good because the ninth house is your spirituality and also it is the higher learning and higher goals. Religion, anything which is coming in the ninth house purview. So Ketu is definitely good there and also it is exalted. So also a good time for you. And Rahu in the third is especially very, very, very good here because the thing is, when Rahu is coming in the third, it will give you good type of effort. And also, as I am mentioning it from my earliest video, that all the malefics enjoy being in third, sixth and 11th house. And Rahu also is a malefic and is very good and comfortable in the third house. So this is also a very good period for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people having Saturn in the 11th and Rahu in the 3rd. So this is also very good. Okay. Now, after that, we can see that no major change, but Mercury, the 7th Lord is going in again in the 8th house. So again, I would like to tell you, relationship is not good at this moment also because the 7th Lord is in the 8th and also in the aspect of Mars and Saturn. So definitely the relationship here, again, I'm telling this is not very good. Relationship will always be a difficult subject for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people at this moment of time. But when we are looking at the career gain and wish fulfillment of other things, name, fame, then and putting in effort and everything, then in that situation, Saturn and Rahu is doing wonderful thing there. Okay. So this was the analysis for the second week. After that, we are having the third week from 30th September till October 6th for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people here. Venus is coming from 5th house to the 6th house. Now, again, this is not a good period for relationship still because 6th house Venus does not feel very, very comfortable and also in the sign of the sun and sun in the 7th house now and the 7th Lord in the 8th house. So this is not a good period because the karaka for relationship is Venus in the 6th house. In for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people, the 7th Lord Mercury is in the 8th house, and in the 7th you are having the 5th Lord, which is the 6th Lord, which is Sun, and Sun is also a malefic, not good for relationship. So at this moment of time, no relationship is good for you. Even if you are married or if you want to get into relationship, please do not go into any new relationship. Try to sustain the marriage and try to hold your partner because this is a really very, very, very testing time for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people in terms of relationship. Relationship will be the hardest subject in this month discussion for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people. Rest, your career is good, your wish fulfillment is good, and everything is good. Okay, now we are coming to the next slide. Next slide is from October 7th till October 14th, and in this the last month, because I am ending the month in before the sun is doing the Sankranti, means transiting of the sun. So before that, the last week from 7th of October till 14th of October, we can see that Mars is incoming in the Lagna. Now, this is also not very good again for the relationship because also it is casting the aspect in the 7th house, and also the 7th Lord is getting afflicted with Mars, and Saturn is afflicting Mercury anyhow. Only the savior is Jupiter because Jupiter is casting its 9th aspect on the Karaka, but there will be dispute. There will be dispute, there will be trouble, and there will be difficulties. So, but overall, when we are looking at the career perspective, the money income, the name and fame thing, it is excellent. Because you see, anything cannot be excellent for everyone. So that one thing you have to take into consideration. And also because Saturn is the 11th Lord, it is very strong in the 11th. So this is a wonderful period for you guys. But relationship is very, very difficult. So I hope that you will definitely work out on your relationship. try not to go into unnecessary arguments with your partner or with the spouse. Try to be calm. And if you are feeling that, yes, there is a difficulty, then definitely talk and sort out the matter. Do not break the communication or do not speak very aggressively, because the more you are aggressive because of the Mars, you are very aggressive, because already we can see that Mars, the second lord in the second house, speaking very aggressive. Now it is coming in the ascendant in the head. So it will make your mind very, very angry and very hot. So try to calm yourself down. And also the Saturn is looking at your ascendant. So please, if you want to have a good relationship and have cordial 1 month in the terms of relationship, then do think properly before speaking to your spouse and try to resolve the matter rather than complicating it. So this was my analysis for Pisces ascendant and Pisces moon sign people. I hope you have liked the video. If you have liked the video, then press the like button, subscribe to my channel Om Astro Jyoti Learning Vedic Astrology, and definitely share this video so that everyone can get the knowledge and get benefited from here. So this is KK Singh signing off for today. Namaskar, God bless, and always be happy. Thank you.